Welcome everybody to NASCAR 08 once again, episode 5 of Earn the Stripes and race 5 of the year in the Busch Series. We are at Atlanta Motor Speedway for the Atlanta 300. Surprise, surprise, we're going to be coming from dead last once again as we just don't at all have single car speed for a qualifying lap, I guess. Kind of was the story at Las Vegas, but we actually ended up winning that race and having a really fast car, so I guess we got past them all once again. And look, she won two in a row for the first time this year. 48 laps would be, if we can get into lap 20s, it could be a one pit stop race. We're three wide, looking four wide. Oh, Atlanta, okay. God, Ambrose, I believe that's you. Give me some room, please. No yellow line, no out of bounds on this track. I believe this was before it was paved to have an out of bounds. Oh, we get to 30 seconds already. Oh gosh. You can actually go. With no upgrades in your car, you can go flat out around this track. This is full throttle, losing a little bit, but we are in dirty air as well. When did this guy become a rival? Oh well. Oh! Just almost got forced onto the apron. Even though it's not out of bounds, you don't really want to be on the apron. Ambrose is in the 59. I'm not sure. He's in the 47. Is that like still or something? I don't know. At the 25th, we get around Harvick. Doesn't really seem like we have a car down the straightaway either. I think it might be a challenge to get to the front today. I try not to tuck the car at all. No matter the qualifying effort. That, 47 is wood. Oh, good. Wow, did he chop my nose. How he and I did not make contact is beyond me. Mears does move up. Fantasy car kind of was holding everybody up. He pounds on the opportunity to get the 18. I keep forgetting who. It's not Mike Wallace. Is it? I feel like I've been over this. That fantasy driver did not want to leave us any room down there. Up to P17. Draft off of Reagan. But yeah, this surface is really smooth. It feels smooth in this car. I wonder what it will have been like with the new gen, or even the old gen, if that being said. If they were around this time of where they separate. Man, the fantasy drivers have been throwing some real bad blocks.
Don't forget, you're one of the good guys.
Just realized I believe there's two Richardsons, me and a fantasy. Dale Jr. to the lead. How do you like that, Junior Nation? Almost the Busch Series. Inside of Casey Kane. we can drive it down. No, he won't. He'll give us some room. The 119. As we are finally getting some speed, just being in the draft, we're making our way forward. Jeff Burton is in the top 10. I think I scrolled through the qualifying to see where he qualified. JJ Yaley falling back a little bit. Looking to the inside for P11 on another fantasy driver. Try to side draft a little bit. Danny Hamlin to the lead. Holding on to that 10th spot. Burton falling back. The outside length really going back. Ooh. I burped there a little bit there. Looked like the inside lane got shut up. Oh, Burton. He's going to try to cut us off. Teammates battle for 10th. We got it right now. Burton real hard side drafts on us. To the back of Junior in the corner. I just would like to be top 10, top 5, mainly top 10 every race, no matter the finish. If we don't have a car to win, I want to try to be in the top 10. We're P7 right now. Junior is able to get back into one spot closer back to being in the top 5. 18. Oh, did not want to leave us any room. Got it all down in 1 and 2. 5th, leading. Conway gets to our inside. I mean, he's got a fast car, but can't just crowd somebody off the track. He had the run, he just was not going to leave any room. I left him room. We fall back to P7. Conway looking to the inside of Junior, trying to get to the top 5 again, and we're going to try to go with him, and we do. So far, the only other winner in the Busch series has been Jeff Burton. And we break into the top 5 now. Galen was in trouble falling out of the top 10 entirely. He's in the top 5. Conway's going to get a big run. He's going to stay behind us. Hamlin and Wallace looking inside. Galen looking inside of Hamlin. We're looking inside of Hamlin. Hamlin goes from 2nd to 5th, maybe to 6th if he's going to. Conway can complete the pass. Got loose off the corner. We got a big run on Yaley. Yaley puts us into the wall. Wow. JJ Yaley throws an aggressive block and just puts us into the wall. We were able to bounce off of it. Not big damage to the car. Gotta be smart with the one. I don't think it's not really a big rival. We're to the inside for P3. We're not gonna pull retaliation and just door slam him for no reason. Denny Hamlin's on his radio crying suspension. Wallace looking to take the lead back though from Biffle. He's to the inside and he's gonna get the pass done. Biffle could go from first to third. And he will. We're at the P2. In our number two. There does seem to be a car off the pace. See if he pulls down into the pit. May have blown an engine. They're coming up on him fast. He is able to make it to the pits. Green flag is going to stay out. Wonder who it was. We've not led a lap today. See if we can before we have to make our first and perhaps only pit stop. Biffle may get a runoff loose. It's a fantasy car, so not really any real problem in the points. And it's more likely done for today. Wallace seems to have a real fast number 7. No, it's not Rusty Ralph. Rusty, but I don't think it's Kenny. I think it's Mike. But I feel like I was wrong before calling him Mike. Right now he's out front leading. Biffle is crowding Garmin here. Tires are starting to go away. Biffle may get a run. Took a peek inside, not able to stay on the corner. Break away from third and fourth for now. Big run to the inside of Wallace, and neither of us could hold it down. Cannot hang on the right side. That side. We were already on the apron. And with the side draft in the corner. Just can't do that in these cars. Don't think it's big damage to have to worry about. We are in the top 10 for speed. And it is Mike Wallace. Okay, so I wasn't wrong. David Reagan and Greg Biffle are the pretty much the fastest ones on the track. Casey Kane has a fast car, so does Palmenard. See where everybody comes out though in the pits. This should be the one and only pit stop today. And I wonder if we got Mike. No, we did not get Mike off the pit road. Come in order. Junior was able to leapfrog, and I believe maybe Yaley and Truex behind him. Biffle did not have a good pit stop. Mike Wallace though with a great restart. Mike trying to lead all the most laps with those 10 bonus points. Junior though, over us, trying to look to the inside, trying to get a run off the 7, off the corner. Mike does not want to leave us any room down here. He's going to have to for 3 and 4. We duck in behind. All over Mike Wallace. Big run exit 3 and 4. Wallace again. What is that? I mean, where was he going to run us? Could only run somebody off the track so far. I never pull him in the wall. I was to his inside the entire time. I don't know how you can say that's my fault. I was in his inside the entire time. Jeff Burton. Leaving us room, that's the perfect way to do it. He's left us room, he's gonna try to side drive Fenner in the corner though. Junior out front. Kevin Harvick had a great pit stop. He's P2. Harvick looking for his first win in the Busch Series. Whatever speed we had in this 2 is probably not down now, thanks to the 7. It's going to be a struggle to hang on to a top 5, top 10 day now. I mean, I'm not saying I had the fastest car or the better car, but he still did not really have to run me off the track multiple times. I mean, I get side drafting for one thing, but come on now. David Reagan looking to the inside of Kevin Harvick. Junebug stays out front. And if we don't lead a single lap in this race, that would be the first race this year we would not lead. So maybe that's why I was racing aggressively against the points leader, but way too early in the year for him to be doing that. And he just ruined his own real good finish. He had a real fast car, but he more likely would have gotten around us again. Reagan putting the pressure on Junior. He had a great exit at 3 and 4. See where he cycled through on all that. Yeah, he's outside the top 10. The dumbass took him out. Took himself out. Getting close to 10 to go. Harvick's crowding our mirror. Reagan looking to the inside of Junior now. David Reagan. To the point for the first time today. We're trying to follow him through for P2. Now Harvick is another one that won at California. Wrecked us to do it. That was one race you guys did not see. Junior looking to the inside of Harvick. It will be 10 to go this time by. Got run on Reagan. was able to chop the nose and stay clear. Didn't really chop our nose, but was able to stay clear of us. And at this point, I really run just P2 and try to make the pass on the final lap. Try to get away from these two behind us. All you gotta do is lead one lap. Last lap was really the only one that mattered. I'd like to have the 10 bonus points, but don't have the best car to do it. The 6 and the 2 working together to get away from the 8 and the 29. We're looking for our third win of the year. Reagan looking for his first. Reagan's got a good gap on us. Thanks to a 7 ticking away, banking on our car. We go to a short track next week in Bristol. That's really the only time to be banging. Somebody. Reagan has a fast car. He was turning fast last time. He had a great pit stop to pull himself up here. So it's not like this pass is going to be any easier. We're getting to him. Is it going to be any easier? We're only going to need a mistake out of the 6. He's actually dusting us. If we didn't have the damage, I think it would be a lot closer, but thanks to the damn 7 beating on our car for no reason. And JJ Yaley did put us in the wall for no reason, but and I'll still take a P2 finish. David Reagan pulling away. Anything for him. Oh, a little bit of a bobble out of Reagan on the exit. We're gonna need a hell of a lot more than that little bobble. Reagan up the track in 1 and 2. As his tire wear is starting to fade. Did he push too soon? Got a good gap on us, but we're gonna need something out of that 6 to get us probably to his bumper, but I don't know. Reagan up the track again. Getting us ever so closer to that 6. Able to hug the line in 3 and 4 really, really well. White flag is out. It's going to be the final attempt. Will there be a front? Will the 6 miss the corner? Up the track in 1 and 2. Way up the track. We get loose on exit. gonna need a problem here in 3 and 4. Reagan up the track. We drive it in. David Reagan. He is gonna cannot get to his corner. Reagan wins at Atlanta. Junior third, Harvick fourth, Jeff Burton, who cares? Or not Jeff Burton. Mike Wallace, who cares? We didn't have the fastest car. And it's also the first race this year we will not lead a single lap. Which is very disappointing. Not do so. Mike Wallace did lead 16 laps, which more than likely was the most on the day. Junior led 10, Reagan led 12 to win it. But yeah, first race this year, RCR does not lead at all. We had an opportunity, the 7 didn't want to give it to us, and we move on to Bristol next week.